In the space of emo rap, there is a huge lack of a definition of what emo rap is. You have many examples like Lil Peep, Lil Tracy / Youngbruh, Juice WRLD, and Black Krae, just to name a few, who all have very different styles but are all placed under the idea of emo rap. But I think there is undeniably someone who has created one of the most interesting emo rap sounds, quite unlike no other who has done it. And if you don't know who I'm talking about Damazan. Formerly known as Max Luis, originally coming from Kingston, Jamaica, but is currently based in the DMV, Damazan originally began as a producer in 2017. After a thorough amount of time producing for others, and he started producing for himself and making his own music, and in 2019 he officially released his first solo singles, Bloodlet. However, it wouldn't be until 2020 he would see interest, as his song Darkness saw a significant amount of buzz on TikTok for both good and bad. Darkness in me, my soul screaming, witchcraft, switchblade. Reason. But publicity is publicity. Originally, he was being memed on for Darkness, as to be fair, it has some questionable bars. For example, in the song, he said the bar, witchcraft, switchblades. Yeah, I'll admit that was pretty corny. But the song besides that is pretty nice, and you can get a real feel for the DMV influence and the trap influence in his sound. It is a literal mixture of emo lyrics on DMV beats, which is something I never thought I'd like, but here we are, and it's very nice. Damazan has probably created one of the most interesting combination of sound, combining DMV rap with elements of rock, punk, emo, and even Jersey Club. But on many of his other tracks, he also mixes in the use of J-pop, and he even manages to add the use of hyperpop and glitchcore into his sound. They need this guy on Kingdom Hearts 4. Square Enix and Disney need to get on that fast. His music is perfect. Which alone is something unheard of, especially DMV rap. Notorious for being heavily placed in scam rap, spice talking, and overall flexing. His topic is much different than the typicals you would find in that area. Common examples would be like Babytron, Stan Will, Kasher Kwan, RMC Mike, Punch Made Dev, Bees, Baby Smooth, and Rio the Young OG, and many more, just to name a few. So I'm sure you're familiar with the sound of DMV as usual, as scam rap, especially Flint and Detroit sound, is extremely popular in the rap game right now, and extremely notable. DMV's usual sound is commonly placed with the use of drugs, spending either legal or illegal money in large quantities, talking about women, talking about how much it costs to live this lifestyle, the price of this lifestyle, expensive cars, expensive clothes, and women, of course, lots of women. But Damazan is an entirely different breed when it comes to his lyrics, and it comes to his production. He takes a much more harmonic and much more beat-oriented approach to his music, so it's less about the lyrics itself, but a lot more about the song as it comes together as a production. Scrapping the usual topics in rap and taking a more rap raw approach in his sound, he practices lyrical honesty very well. Like I said, his lyrics are very emo-centric to being with. His music strongly reminds me of Juice WRLD. Not in a flow-biting way, but just because the emo rap genre is pretty expansive, but kind of limited in examples, his sound doesn't strongly remind me of Black Krae, Peep, or Tracy. But in the production and the vocals, he does kind of remind me of Juice, thoroughly. And compared to the other options, this is just about the best comparison you could make. If you're familiar with my content, I am a huge praiser of versatility in artists, their ability to flesh out their sound, but also be able to make and produce new and interesting content. And I'm especially fond of people who take a genre and bend it in their own way. And Damazan, with his emo DMV, is just like that. He takes a new approach to emo trap, and it's definitely something refreshing. As for his discography, he released primarily singles until 2019. When he released a full-length album, Spirit Possession Ceremony, and I gotta say, for the genre and for the earliness of his career, he did a very good job with this album. I would rate it a solid 8 out of 10. After that, he continued to release a lot more singles and a lot of collabs even. He's not afraid to collab. Now, as of his newer discography, for about 5 songs in a project, I would say that Damazan has not missed in quite a bit, honestly. His collaborations and his entire Dark Pocket EP is some of my favorite stuff. The entire year of 2022 and 2023, he has not released a bad song. The rest of his discography is also extremely good itself, but I personally believe that his very recent discography has been... he cannot compete with it in terms of the rest of his songs. Dying, Ancient Echoes, Burning Angel, and You Washed Away are so good. Just those handful are good enough. His older discography is also extremely good itself, but I feel like he has really burned a new road in his career with these more recent songs, as the production, vocals, and just the overall sound of his songs has been so good, and it's been so expansive. His work with Kim J has much more of a Jersey Club and much more of an upbeat feel, but his work with Young Van and Sorry X is much more emotional, and you can really feel the songs. He has released an EP extremely recently called Dark Pocket in collaboration with Kim J that has been very well received, gaining tens of thousands of listens in no time at all. We're talking about short of a month. And all the songs are very unique in that project. From the harmonies and storytelling on To The Sun, to the lyrics and harmonies and beat of Burning Angel, to the beat and energy of Afterlife, he has quite a bit of versatility and a quite great sound to his music overall. And he is no stranger to collaboration, like I said. Damazane has collabed with the likes of Young Van, Young City, Sorry X, and a frequent collaborator of his production-wise is Kim J. And he doesn't lean on his collaborators. He delivers on both his solo and collab tracks and has multiple very well done solo tracks in his album. Damazane's music is insanely good and very unique to that. But as I raved about his DMV sound, Damazane does, like I said, he has a lot of versatility in his discography. He bounces from sound to sound. No two songs from his discography sound exactly the same, which is something I deeply appreciate with him, and his music especially with his recent songs. His start as a producer is also additional to his sound, as it has given him a lot of creative freedom. His sound is very dynamic from song to song, especially with his collaboration with Kim J. Kim J is a very popular producer, working with big names like Eric DOA, No Cap, and even the extremely popular Connie. Gaining multiple tracks with him and only helping solidify Damazane's sound further and refine it. So being a frequent collaborator with him is only just adds to the quality of his music. Damazane, in terms of beat selection, has many, many different types. From his typical DMV sound to his emo trap to Jersey Club to even Rage and Regalia beats, he has a nice spread of sound. His sound is very well versed and there is something for everybody if you're willing to give his music a listen. From a production standpoint, his music is extremely good, from beat to vocals to mixing. His sound is unique, authentic, and versatile, and when you live in an underground economy where everybody wants to sound like the same five people, everybody wants to sound like Destroy Lonely, Ken Carson, Summers, Yeet, and there are so many newer people in the underground who are just biting flows and biting sounds, trying to blow up, Damazane takes something and does something utterly unique. Now granted, are there plenty of people that you can compare him to in his sound? Yes, like I said, he's comparable to a lot, but he doesn't get that close ever to straight up flow biting like a lot of these other artists do. And no, I wasn't talking about Dom Corleo. And he has a very unique privilege that a lot of artists don't have, and that his music would be perfect for not just like mainstream appeal, but I could see this guy doing video game soundtracks, I could see him doing anime openings and closings. Like, his music is perfect in that way. His music marketability is way too real, and his talent is unprecedented. It's an ongoing joke in his community that he sounds like a Kingdom Hearts rapper, and they're not wrong. He would literally be perfect on Kingdom Hearts 4. That all being said, Damazane is a musical anomaly. He has a very refreshing sound in the space that he takes inspiration from, and he's comparable to some artists, but he's also unique enough to really have him be out there. I'm a thorough enjoyer of his music, and I have been for months, and I would advise anyone who is interested to get into his music if you like the video. And if you're intrigued by any of the music I put in the video, please go check out his page, because he has not only those songs, but a lot more, and the quality of his music is literally insane. That being said, if you enjoyed the video, please like, please sub, please turn on notifications. It costs nothing and it supports me a lot. And I also wanted to say, I recently put out an announcement that I will be doing a content tour. If you don't know what a content tour is, basically, it's like a subathon. Celebrating the recent growth of my channel and today literally being my birthday, I thought I would do something special for everybody. And next week, August 1st to August 7th, I will be doing a couple things that would be very interesting for my viewers. First off, for 7 days, for that entire week from the 1st to the 7th, there will be daily uploads. I will have pre-prepared content that I release daily for you guys. And the content following that week, I will put up polls where everybody can vote what they would want to see out of some options. Thirdly, I will be putting the links for my Twitch and my Kick, as I will be also mixing in some streaming and possibly even some collabs with some friends of mine who make content and make music and do all kinds of stuff. And lastly, if you're interested in any of that, please stick around, go sub to the Twitch, go sub to the Kick, and I think you're also going to want to stick around because I'm finally opening the ETK official Discord. It will be open by that time and it will be crazy. For everybody and anybody who's interested and who has been hanging around, whether you're a new fan or an old fan, I appreciate everybody, and I wanted to do this for you all and for the sake of the growth of my channel. So if anybody is still watching at this point in the video, please be ready for all that. But I got it. It seems like love.